But in Aberdeen, Maryland, one gypsy man is going about life and love in his own unique way.
Well, they call me Crazy Swayze because I love Patrick Swayze and I'm also crazy. Now, for all the ladies, Patrick Swayze, the dirtiest dancer. That's his actual tombstone. I love Patrick Swayze because he's such a great actor, such a ladies' man. And how could you not love dirty dancing? 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. No spaghetti arms. 1, 2, 1, 2. Well, I'm 232 pounds of muscle, steel, and sex appeal. What you see is what you get, and what you don't see is better yet. Good friends, good times, man.
Crazy Swayze, or Pee-wee, is defying gypsy courting rules and taking a modern approach to finding a wife.
The summer while I was out working, I met a girl over the internet. I fell for her because of her personality. We just connected. We became best friends. She's done got my heart. Oh my gosh.
Despite months of texting and phone calls, Pee-wee has never met his online girlfriend in person.
Talked to her on the internet, but never met her. That's how crazy I get. And I says, how about the first time we meet, we'll just make it special and just go get married.
I thought it was like the coolest thing, so I said, yeah, and it just happened.
The girl that stole his heart is 21-year-old single mom, Brittany.
And my finger.
A non-gypsy, otherwise known as a gorger.
I was going through a rough time. He just been smiling. We've been talking ever since.
Hey.
Hi.
This is your lover. Yeah, I can't wait to see you on that wedding day.
Got the whole day planned, you know?
Every time I talk to him, even when we get off the phone, I just sit there and smile and think about him. He makes me happy. I can't stop saying that.
So, can you wait to see me?
No, I want to see you so bad.
How bad do you
want to see me on a scale of 1 to 10?
100, duh.
100?
Yeah. Damn!
Brittany's that missing piece of the puzzle. Like, she has my heart. I got hers. That's all there is to it. Like, two people in love. That's an American story right there.
I'll do is, you know, I'll call you tomorrow.
All right.
Bye-bye.
A bunch of chavvies running down to the lake.
Brittany has no concerns about becoming the wife of a Romanichal.
Oh, I'm proud to be a gorger, but going into a gypsy family, I think I can handle it because I can, like, live to most of their ways. My mom's sister married my Uncle Gary, and he's a gypsy, and their kids are gypsies.
Blade, you ain't eating that. Pee-wee has changed her a lot because lately she will not go out and have a good time. She always wants to stay on the phone and talk to him.
I'll marry a gypsy boy because they're all out there and crazy and loopy, just like Pee-wee is.
And the gorger bride has agreed to a traditional gypsy wedding.
I'm gonna throw her the best gypsy wedding ever. I'm gonna spoil her. I'm gonna make sure that she has the most beautiful dress.
Nervous. Oh, really scared.
As the guests gather at the wedding venue, Pee-wee becomes more and more excited.
Can I get a picture, please?
I got it.
Like, it's my wedding day. I can't believe we have never met. And it's so crazy that it is my wedding day.
Oh, pussycat, pussycat. Nice. Put a pussycat. Woo!
The moment when Brittany will finally meet the man she's going to spend the rest of her life with is fast approaching.
Well, I'm so scared.
What if you don't like him?
He'll like me.
Oh, he will so like you. Don't even say that. He's so in love with you. That, don't ever say that because he really, truly is in love with you and he hasn't even met you yet.
I do fine.
Yeah, it's a good time. I never thought I would ever get married. Really didn't. I was never one to settle down. The closer we get, the better I'm going to get because I finally get to meet Brittany, you know?
So beautiful. Like, as a Romanichal, I've never seen anything more special. Ever, ever. As long as my wife's happy and I'm happy, that's all that matters.
But an unexpected guest has arrived. Pee-wee's mom, Lottie.
Guess what? Maybe today.
When my mom showed up, I was happy because I thought she was there to show a little bit of support for her son.
Unfortunately, Lottie has a different agenda.
I'll stop the wedding. Remember that Earl Stewart Gribble? When I say your full name, watch out. Mama's coming out. Bang, bang.
Hey, if you don't want Pappy, talk to me, sir. Tell Pappy don't talk to me. Well, you're telling me to let it go.
Can we get the bride so I can get married so I can get the hell up out of here?
If I say you can, be embarrassed of Brittany's father, of Brittany's family, okay? Don't be embarrassed of your mother, okay?
He said, I embarrass him. How can a son tell the mother you embarrass them? That's when I blew up.
Have the Harper County Sheriff come and get me. And
that's my sister's body.
That's so fucking embarrassing, I swear to God.
When I hopped out of that, I saw buttons going everywhere. I was done. I didn't even want to get married no more.
It was terrible. Like, when he ripped his suit off, I thought the wedding was over.
She's a fucking tabby. This is so embarrassing. You can leave, too.
As a mother, you don't do that to your son.
Like, I don't give a fuck if it's my mom or not. Like, she's not going to disrespect Brittany or her fucking family. Don't even worry about
me. Bride Brittany is just moments away from meeting her husband-to-be, Pee-wee, for the very first time.
No.
She's blissfully unaware of the drama unfolding at the altar.
That's so embarrassing to like the people I'm getting ready to fucking get married to.
After having a fight with Pee-wee, his disapproving mum Lottie has stormed off, hell-bent on finding Brittany.
Listen, that's my wife. We had a little bit of a problem, because nobody's going to get in my wife's face. That's my wife.
I was talking to your grandfather, okay? My stupid son told me I am bad.
I don't know what Lottie was flipping out about. Something like Pee-wee was taking up for my family, and then she got mad. She just wanted to yell.
Listen to me about my son.
Like, I'm not trying to sugarcoat it, but this family is fucking nuts.
Get that out of my face, bud! Knock the top of your head off!
Looky here.
No, it ain't looky here!
I'm telling you, she's loony. But don't forget, when she gets old enough, I'm putting her in a home.
Guess what I told him? Is he embarrassed of your family? Nah.
Pee-wee has no choice but to intervene.
Pee-wee can't come up here.
Please leave.
No, if I gotta leave, Brittany's family gotta leave.
But Brittany is whisked away before Pee-wee arrives. And Lottie just won't give up.
Oh my God!
Pee-wee rushes to defend his bride.
Get up, get back!
The first time I wanted to lay eyes on Brittany is that moment where I get to see her, her wedding dress, get to see all the reaction of the people being like, oh, that's a nice dress. But instead, I'm over here grappling my mother on the ground.
Mom, I don't give a fuck. Why are you doing this to me on my fucking day?
You hate Lily.
Why are you doing this to me?
My mom ruined my wedding. Okay, let's be honest.
No more.
Pee-wee, he's the one who caused it, the whole shing-ding. Kept in my face, that's my wife, that's my wife. Well, what kind of wife you got if she don't want to meet Mama Bear?
Like, we went from all the drama, and then, like, Pee-wee, like, yelled at his mom, and he made his mom leave. And, like, after she left, everything went, like, smoothly.
Can I go get fucking married?
Yeah, you can.
Hey, I'm doing good.
I'm out.
After Lottie left, the first time I saw him, he wore cuteness, orange tuxedo.
I saw Brittany. She's everything I expected her to be. She smiled. She was just my princess. Same person I talked to on the internet. She was right there.